KTM has blurred the lines between sport and comfort, taking all the benefits of an automated transmission, but keeping it ready to race with the focus on the rider. To explain more about the AMT and the transmission, we've got a guest here, Sasha.
Hello, Dieter. Thanks for the invitation.
Sasha, first question, AMT, what does it mean?
So AMT means automated manual transmission. At first, we can see that we have no clutch lever anymore. The clutch operation is now done with a mechanical flywheel clutch system. The gear drum movement is done with an electronic actuator. So the rider can choose with a manual operation, like pedal buttons, to select gears with the conventional foot shift lever or with a fully automatic shift mode.
Now, Sasha, talking about the AMT gearbox is really interesting, but why don't we dive closer into mechanical works and see how it works?
Yes, for sure. Let's have a closer look.
Cool.
So, Dieter, here you can see the main parts of the AMT system. At first, the new handlebar switches with the pedal buttons to select the gears, and the AM button to switch between manual mode and automatic mode. This is our completely new developed clutch, the flywheel clutch, but the secret are these two plates. So here you can see the weights. So depending on the engine speed, the weights are moving to the outside. And with this plate, the clutch engage and disengage by itself. So if you want to select a gear, you press the pedal button, the signal is sent to the ECU. The ECU calculates the target angle and requests this from the transmission control unit. The transmission control unit, with its electronic actuator, rotates the gear drum to the selected gear.
Sasha, but the rider can also ride in a fully automated mode.
This is correct. The rider has only to press one button on the right handlebar switch, then he is in a fully automatic shift mode. The ECU will calculate the correct target gear depending on the actual riding situation.
That's quite interesting because, as you mentioned to me, the rider can choose different shift modes, and that's all dependable on the ride mode he's in, correct?
This is correct. So the rider can choose, depending on the ride mode, the AMT shift mode in the fully automatic shift mode. Yeah.
The rider can also choose between three different ride modes. Sasha, can you explain to us the three ride modes that we've got?
Yeah, in the fully automatic shift mode, you can select between sport, street, and comfort.
With the three different ride modes, it also changes the engine behavior, Sasha. What exactly changes?
This is correct. So if you select the comfort mode, the engine operates on a very low RPM level and the dynamic shift adaptations are switched off. In the street mode, you have a very harmonized engine RPM level, so in the middle level, and the dynamic shift adjustment, so if you make a hard braking maneuver, is activated. And in the sport mode, the engine operates in a higher RPM level and you have always the correct gear for your maximum acceleration.
3, 2, 1, go!
Really giving the rider choices to focus on the different riding environments that they're in. And I think that's one of the crucial parts of this AMT transmission. Now, Sasha, looking at the bike, we also have a different gearbox setup because we've got a park mode as well.
This is correct. Because of the flywheel clutch, this is a normally open clutch. That means the clutch without engine revolution is always open and the bike will run away if you park it on a downhill situation. And therefore, we implemented a very smart parking lock in the transmission. The rider has only to pull the brake and press the down button, and then the system will shift to the park position and the rear wheel is locked against runaway.
So one of the cool, interesting parts is the fact that there's no rear brake lever on the handlebar. Because if we're looking at competitor bikes, Some of them have got the extra brake lever on the handlebar with an extra set of brake pads, but that of course adds extra weight to the bike.
This is correct. This is one big point of our system. We adding only 1 kilogram compared to a conventional bike.
That's incredible. Now, we've talked about slightly what is AMT. We've spoken about how the gear shifts work, but now manual, because that's where the M part comes in. How do I ride in manual mode?
If the rider selects the manual mode, he has the choice to select the gears with the pedal buttons or to select it with the conventional foot shift lever. In the manual mode, you're completely free. So only if the bike comes to a standstill situation or the actual gear doesn't fit anymore to the actual vehicle speed, the system will shift down by itself.
Now, manual mode, to engage that, it's as simple as pressing the AM button. That's when I engage manual mode. For that, we've got, like Sasha, you mentioned now, we've got the handlebar gear switches where I can switch gears on the handlebar or the foot lever. But explain to us, the foot lever is also different because there's no, it's not connected to the gearbox.
Correct. So we have no direct connection to the shift drum. So the shift shaft is now replaced by the electronic actuator. And the foot shift lever itself is only a sensor which detects the shift requests up or down.
Keeping it ready to race, and for those guys that want full control, what happens in manual mode if I hit the rev limiter? Will the bike change gears or not?
So this in the end is your choice. You can select in the dashboard the over rev protection shift for the manual mode, so you can decide if the system shall shift on the optimal point or entering the rev limiter.
Oh, that's incredible, because it's really cool how I can now change the bike for my needs. If I don't want the bike to shift gears, I deactivate that, or if I want the bike to shift gears, I can keep it on. Now, we've spoken, Sasha, about manual transmission and how it works. But now, how does it work when I'm in auto mode and I just want to go slightly to manual to assist myself? What options do I have?
So for sure, in the automatic mode, you can always overrule the system. So you can manual shift down, for example, for your overtaking maneuver, or you have a functionality on the accelerator. With a fast rotation of the accelerator, the system will shift down one gear.
And then also, if I overclose the throttle, I can preempt the gear change as well.
This is correct. This is more or less the third option of manual shifting. We implemented an overclosing downshift for the manual mode.
Now, Sasha, having these three options in automated mode, why would I want it? Because that's always the question that guys come back to us. What's the reason?
Yeah. Also, an automatic mode cannot find the correct gear for every riding situation. So the rider should always possible to overrule the actual target calculation.
So examples would be when I want to overtake a vehicle. So I'm sitting behind a vehicle and I quickly want to overtake it to get into the correct gear and not waste that time. Or when I'm getting those nice sporty passes or a tight pass and I really want to overtake my friend quickly, I can preempt the gears beforehand.
Correct, yeah.
AMT also allows customization for the riders with different user modes. Sasha, what do we mean by that?
Yes, we implemented 4 AMT user options. The first one is linked to the manual mode. That means over rev protection upshift. So you can decide if the system, also in the manual mode, shall shift up if you come to the area of the rev limiter. The second user option is linked to the automatic mode. This is the kickdown function. So if you do a very fast opening operation on your accelerator, the system will shift down one gear. The third one is an additional manual shift trigger. This is the overclosing downshift function. You can also decide if you want to use it or not. And the fourth one is the inverted foot shift lever layout, so you can decide what happens on a lever down or lever up operation.
It's really interesting how we're looking at all the future models and how you can then change the gear lever with which direction the gears work in.
Correct. This is the main intention for sure for the racetrack use. You can set it like a MotoGP bike, so lever down, gear up.
Wow, really cool, all the rider functionalities that we've got there. One of the main points of AMT is also the integration with our ACC, Adaptive Cruise Control. Sasha, how do we make sure the AMT and ACC work closer together?
So the ACC system and the AMT system are now fitting very good because you can set the AMT in an automatic mode and the ACC will keep the distance to the vehicle in front of you and you don't care about shifting the gears.
One of the main benefits of the integration of the ACC and AMT is that when the vehicle in front of you comes to a complete standstill, is that the AMT system will shift all the way down to first gear. Is that correct, Sasha?
Yeah, this is correct. So the system will engage the first gear for your next ride away.
Now, Sasha, AMT, let's quickly go through the highlights. What's the main benefit of a rider and why do I want to choose an AMT system?
As you said, so the rider doesn't care anymore about the clutch lever operation. The flywheel clutch system engage and disengage depending on the engine RPM by itself. So you can easily open the accelerator and drive away very smoothly. To keep it ready to race for sure, the shift selection is done with a quick shift operation. So if you press the pedal button with a manual trigger, the shift will be executed in a 50 milliseconds duration. And for sure, for low load riding, the shift quality is improved in this system.
Sasha, for the AMT system, there were certain criteria that we focused on when developing it. And immediately a question for mind for me comes to wheelie. Can I wheelie an AMT system?
So with this bike, we have a very powerful engine and for sure, only by opening the throttle with the correct gear, you can do a wheelie.
And off-road riding, how does it handle a bit more gravel roads?
So also in the gravel road situation, so it's much more easier, for example, for a non-experienced rider, because he doesn't care about the clutch. He can leave his foot on the foot pegs and select the gears manually with the pedal buttons.
This bike in front of us is the bike that Johnny Obad raced with at the Iron Road Prologue in the Red Bull Erzberg Rodeo. And after seeing how well the gearbox handled that tough environment, we are pleased to say it's ready to race. And this gearbox will be coming out in multiple models in the future. So keep your eyes peeled and you'll soon see them out on the road.